Hola, welcome back to step 6 of step by step Spanish. Today we are going to do the concept which is the most important thing in any grammar of the word, which is the verb or the action word. Before we start the verbs, I would like to brush up on a few things. What is the infinitive form of the verb? The infinitive form of the verb is the basic form of the verb. Like the verb in English is to eat. So, to eat is the verb, but when you use that in the sentence, you don't say I to eat an apple, or you don't say he to eats in the restaurant. You change that verb, you change that basic form of the verb according to the subject in order to use that in the sentence, which is called the conjugation of the verb. Conjugation means changing the basic verb form as per the subject. And the same concept we have in Spanish also. So let us start with the concept of verbos. En español, todos los verbos terminan en AR, ER o IR. That means that the basic infinitivo form means the infinite form of the verb, the basic root form of the verb in Spanish would always end in either AR, ER or IR. The verb cannot have any other ending apart from this. And the verb can be regular or the verb can be irregular. Now, what do you mean by that? A regular verb is the verb that follows the rules of the conjugation that we will just do. And the irregular verb is the verb which will not follow the rules of the conjugation. Even if it doesn't follow that in one subject, we consider that irregular. Today we are going to do el verbo regular AR en presente. So today we are going to do the regular AR ending verbs in present. So before we conjugate the verb, let us write the 6 sujetos that we learned in the previous video, which were yo, tú, él, ella, usted, nosotros, nosotras, vosotros, vosotras, ellos, ellas, and ustedes. So let us take one verb, which is hablar. Hablar means to speak. Now, how do I conjugate the verb? To conjugate a verb which ends in AR or to conjugate a regular verb which ends in AR, we remove AR and we add these endings. For yo, we add O. For tú, we add AS. For él, ella, usted, we add A. For nosotros, nosotras, we use AMOS. For vosotros, vosotras, we use AIS. Be very careful with the position of acento or tilde over here. And for ellos, ellas, ustedes, we use AN. Hablar in itself means to speak. But when I say hablo, it means I speak. When I say hablas, it means you speak. When I say habla, it means he or she or you being formal speak. Hablamos, we all speak. Hablais, you all speak. Hablan, they all speak. Now, if you pay attention, none of these endings are same. So, hablo can only mean I speak. Hablas can only mean you speak. First, the endings are different. There is no scope for confusion about which subject am I talking about. That is why in Spanish, generally, we do not use the subjects. Because for example, in English, I say, I eat in a restaurant. If I just say, eat in the restaurant, it will not make complete sense because it can be, I eat in the restaurant, or same verb form is used for different subject. That is why in English, it is mandatory to put the subject. But in Spanish, the verb gives us the information about which subject we are talking about. That is why generally, we don't say, yo hablo. You simply say, hablo. Okay, but yes, if you want to clarify, for example, to say he speaks Spanish and she speaks French, so if you want to differentiate or if you want to stress on any particular subject, yes, you can use the subject, but generally you would see Spanish speaking people, generally they do not use the subject. Why? Because the verb tells us which subject are we talking about. Similarly, here I have written a couple of more verbs and I will conjugate them with you. Bailar, which means to dance. So how will I conjugate bailar? Again, following the same rule, bailo, which means I dance, bailas, which means you dance, baila, he or she or you being formal, dances, Bailamos. We all dance. Bailáis. And bailan. And I would suggest that you just pause the video and try to conjugate this verb cantar on your own before I conjugate cantar. And once you are done, you can restart the video again. Cantar means to sing. So the conjugation of cantar, which I'm sure you have done by now, it is canto, cantas, canta, cantamos, cantáis, and cantan. So this is how you conjugate the regular AR verbs in the presente or in the present tense. Now that we know the verbs and the nouns, let us try to make some sentences. I want to say I dance a lot in the party. So I can say yo bailo. A lot is mucho. In the party. En la fiesta. I know you want to make a lot of sentences, and for that you need a lot of vocabulary. In the description, I am also giving you the link of the online dictionary that I personally use. I would only recommend not to use Google because it is not always correct. Try to use the dictionary that I use, is a trusted one. Similarly, if I want to say she sings very well, so then it can become ella, which again is optional. Canta muy bien. If I want to say we all speak English a lot in India, so it can be nosotros. Again, nosotros is optional. Hablamos mucho el inglés. See, because it is the name of a language, so masculine. Nosotros hablamos mucho el inglés en la India. So guys, don't hesitate to practice and make a lot of sentences. Please feel free to make mistakes because that is very important to learn. So try to do the task which is given in the description of this video. And apart from that, you can find a lot of online exercises on Google as well. You can try to do them as well. And if you have any doubt or any concern related to that, please feel free to write in the comment section and I will try to answer you soon. Friends, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And I will see you all again very soon. Adios!